Okay, yesterday my wife and I were out here chilling up the garden to get rid of all the okra, what I call tree stumps, because they're as thick as tree stumps. We used that little, what I want to refer to as a Civil War era tiller. You see that thing right there, it's old. And that the axle right there, the center hole there, it's about 8 inches roughly to the end of those tines. That's how far down we went. The front, the front of that was down almost to the ground. We didn't want to go down in the ground, my wife and I both. But there's no reverse. The belts are, I got a new belt on there and an old one. I'm waiting for it to break on me. But it's all manual, man. It was rough as hell. But see, I did this one and this one. This is garden number one. And garden number two, I did those a couple months, within the last 2 months. But it's all lumpy, it's not even. My wife and I did this one here. You can see the row of leaves right there. We had this plastic folded in half, and then we pulled it all the way down over there to the end there, and we tilled all this out and made it fairly even actually underneath here, underneath the plastic. All the holes were where we previously had stuff. The okra was over here, about where, see those big holes? That's where the okra was at, all over in there. And it went that way. We had the black, purple hull peas in the first row over there, and then black-eyed peas, and zucchini, and then we had black-eyed peas, and purple hull peas, black-eyed peas, and then zucchini. And then we had watermelon and pumpkin, cantaloupe and such. I'm not going to step on that plastic. I don't want to ruin that because it's such a good looking, even stepping on the plastic on this, which is all real lumpy. This right here is going to be sunflowers all the way around the garden. A big giant U around this garden. It'll attract butterflies, the big butterflies too, like, you know, I mean the real big winged ones you saw in the earlier video. Plus we've had quite a few monarchs out here. The hummingbirds go into them, and also bees, honeybees, real honeybees, because they helped pollinate all the stuff we had out here. So the middle there, that was our walkway in between the two small gardens in front here. That's where we're going to put our garlic here in about within the next week. But here's the trench. It's got to be done. See, it's starting to grow again. That's why it's going to have to be tilled up here probably tomorrow. It goes all the way down here. I'm going to have a peanut plant, which would be like three or four peanuts down in there in the corner. See, this is growing up quite a bit here. See how the green, you can see the line still all the way down. Right there, you know. And then it goes on the other side over there like this here. So it's a big U. So that'll be sunflowers. It'll be those torch sunflowers and the traditional yellow, the yellow face ones. Titan, and I can't recall what the other one was called, but the torch are the ones that are orange. Those are the ones that really attract the butterflies and the honeybees and even the hummingbirds. Yeah, like I said, we used that old tiller. It took us a couple hours to do that too, man. I mean, we tilled down about 8 inches into the ground, all the way up to where that fold is, where those leaves are. Really nice looking too. I mean, there's a lot of good soil. I mean, it really, really, it did surprise me compared to the rest of the garden that I had done. I never tilled it down as far as as my wife and I did. See, I did more over here because we were digging up the roots of the, what do you call them? Okra plants. Little CJ. See, here's the okra plants. My wife was pulling them out after I would till them. So I was trying to hold on. See, this, it wasn't really easy to do with that tiller, so I had to man the tiller to get these up. But you can see, they're like little trees. And there was like 27, 28 all total out here. But as we dug, as my wife was pulling them up, and she tossed them over here. And man, it's rough. So I gotta get those and get them across the road in the ditch or something. But that's what we got up yesterday. And this next season, we're gonna put tomatoes over here. We're gonna try to go five, it'll be five deep, like three rows across. So we'll have 15 tomato plants out here, which hopefully it'll produce a lot better than they did this year. This year we had a major problem with hornworms. I keep saying hookworms, hornworms. These were where my sunflowers were at this year. But I'm going to have to dig all that up as they grow in the spring. Because the big U I have around the garden. I'd still like to try getting some... I can't even think of the flower out front here. It helps deter mosquitoes around the outer edge of the two front gardens here. Anyhow, come on. I tore up all the peppers except for a few. I didn't realize that there would be peppers growing still. See, our growing season usually ends around the end of October. About the third week of October is when you're done. But like I said, if I had left stuff out here, they would still have grown. It would slow down. But like, look at these peppers. See this one here? There's one right there. I don't know if you can see it on there. There's a couple flowers on there. There's a flower on that one right there where pepper will grow out if it doesn't get real cold. We've had a frost, but it wasn't a bad frost. It got down to probably even just like around 33 out here, 32 degrees, 34 degrees. It'll freeze out here. Not bad, just enough. And that was my worry, and I just went ahead and pulled everything up except for these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 pepper plants. You know, and I left, that's where I left. And like I said, there's peppers on them, and we're just going to see how they go. You know, if we get a major frost and all that, I'll just go ahead and have to pull out the rest of them. See if we can get any more peppers out of it. But those are the torch sunflowers right there. We're going to put them... Those cinder blocks were to go around this garden here where the peppers were. I was gonna raise it up. We have to get like about 12 or 20 bags of that potting soil to put on top of here. I till it as best I can because there's a lot of roots down there for like this tree and such. And there was another tree out here. This is the oldest, one of the oldest standing log cabins. Goes back to 1880 and 1890, somewhere in there, and plus they added on to it, of course. But those cinder blocks are going to make like a little raised garden. I'm not going to go as long. I got enough to go almost as long as I have with these little boards. But I'm going to put these torch sunflowers right here, a few, around my chimney there, which is for decoration, trust me. Then in front of, by the windows here around this. But look, see here, where's that? I did this yesterday and the video didn't transfer, so I'm redoing it today. Like, there's a bee. There was one on another flower up on top here last night. So, these are really, really, I didn't know these would be as pretty as they are. The seeds that come off of these things, the seed is like this here. This will dry out and all that, and it'll be real prickly like. And it's like you pluck them out with tweezers. And you have seeds in there. And I'm telling you, you get probably about 40, 50 seeds at least from each head after it's all dried out. I showed you on that too. I've got two small snack bags out front that are pretty full. I have enough seeds to do all the way around this garden five times, six times. And then, like I say, out in front. Petey, come on, buddy. So, I'm going to see if this will transfer. I did a video yesterday. I was so sore, my knees were hurting. My wife and I both were tired, and I'm telling you, it was rough. All I can say is, if you can get a small place, even a 5-gallon bucket, not that, but you know, we bought some from Kmart, and buy a bag of potting soil for each bag, for each bucket. Grow you a tomato plant. Grow you a pepper plant. I don't know, grow whatever you want to grow, but just get like a 5-gallon bucket. And probably about one bag of potting soil for each bucket, maybe not quite as much, maybe almost 2/3 of the bag. But, my knees are still hurting, but not as bad. See, Well, we got the cans out there too. See, this is kind of, this is not the ones we got from Kmart, but it's a 5 gallon bucket like that. That big pecan tree has got about 80% pecans. That one's got 80%. I don't know, that one back there has got the small ones. That's why we really don't worry about that one so much, but I'll get some. I already got about 600 or 700 pecans, which would fill up to about the top of that pink line right there, right about there. And I'd like to get 2 5-gallon buckets, and that'd be more than enough. We'd shell them and freeze them and then have them to eat or to make stuff with. And year before last, or 2 years ago, we were out here and we got 3 or 4 or 5 gallon buckets of pecans. Plus, other people were coming out here and getting them. I mean, the landlord's wife was out here, and friends of the family, and just strangers that asked if they could. And I said, sure, it's not, I don't have a problem. It's not really even mine, really, per se, in a way it is, but it was nice they asked for permission, and they picked up a lot. You know, so, I mean, pecans are good on some years, and some years they waned. Last year was like hardly, you could probably get 2 pocketfuls, and that was it. So, and with the spraying and stuff, that's my major concern. You know, I'm wearing a face mask right now, a surgical face mask, as you can see real quick. See it right there? Okay.